नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम डॉक्टर रश्मि अग्रवाल, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ऑब्स्टेट्रिक गायनेकोलॉजी। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज यूएसजी इंडिकेशन। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टडीड यूएसजी, अबाउट यूएसजी, व्हाट इज यूएसजी, what are the purpose of USG. Here we study the uses of USG or indication of USG. So common USG, common uses or indication of the obstetrical USG. Obstetrical ultrasound is useful clinical test to first is establish the presence of living embryo or fetus. Means what is the presence of living embryo, if embryo is live or dead in the intrauterine life. So we can detect it by USG examination. Second is estimate the age of pregnancy. We can understand about the age of pregnancy means if female forget the period of menses, last menstrual period. So we can estimate the age. What was the age? And when we calculate the EDD, then by the USG examination, we can calculate the age of pregnancy. Okay. Diagnose congenital abnormalities of fetus. Congenital abnormalities like many abnormalities, IUGR, cleft palate, cleft lip, spina bifida, these are many abnormalities. So we can detect or diagnose these abnormalities in the fetus. Next is evaluate the position of fetus. Evaluate the position of fetus. We study the position of fetus like breech presentation, vertex presentation, bro presentation. Okay. So position also like transverse, longitudinal. So we can determine the position of fetus. So it is easy for future purpose. Future purpose means if we know about the position of fetus, then we can decide the next purpose, like if it will be the vaginal delivery or cesarean delivery, then this is very helpful for outcoming the labor process. Then evaluate the position of placenta. Position of placenta, you know about the what is the position or what is the abnormal things about the placenta. Placenta previa, placenta accreta, these are many things. So if we know about the position of placenta, then it is also helpful for labor process. Okay. See here. Next, determine to multiple pregnancies. Multiple pregnancies, many, maybe twins or triplets or quadruplets. So it is also helpful for determining the multiple pregnancies. Determine the amount of amniotic fluid around fetus. How much quantity is in the uterus? So it is helpful also for cesarean or vaginal delivery. and also it is helpful for fetus. Either it is in comfort form or not. So it is very helpful. Amniotic fluid, very helpful. Then check for cervical effacement. Cervical effacement, you know about the cervical effacement in the labor process. So cervical, how much cervical dilatation is occurring in that process? So we can calculate, or we can calculate the time which is spending during labor process. So next is assess fetal growth. Fetal growth, either fetus is growing or non-growing. So we can manage it through antenatal care. Then assess fetal well-being. Fetus is okay or not. So fetal well-being, fetal properly growing or not growing, also it is related to fetal growth. Then suspected hydatidiform mole. Hydatidiform mole, you know about, or you learn about the hydatidiform mole or vesicular mole. So these are also anomalies, and we can detect by the USG examination. Suspected fetal death. Fetal death, if either fetal is live or non-live. So maybe calculating or may detect the fetal death. Then suspected uterine abnormalities. Uterine abnormalities, uterus is, you know about the uterine congenital abnormalities. So here we can also understand about this USG examination. IUCD localization. So what is the position of IUCD? Either in the place or not. We can understand by the USG examination. Development of ovarian follicle in case of ovulation studies and infertility treatment. Here, you know, in the learn about in the infertility chapter, development of ovarian follicle. Ovarian, some females is not fertile for many years. So we study the these cases by ovulation study. So here we also detect the growth of ovarian follicle. Ovarian follicle in the case of infertility treatment. And by this, we can manage these cases. Biophysical profile after 28 weeks of gestation. Biophysical profile after 28 weeks of gestation. 28 weeks of gestation means 7 months or 7 to 7.5 months. Then we detect what are the changes in uterus. Then observation of intrapartum events. Intrapartum events during labor process, we can detect what are the changes. Either uterus is properly contracted or not contracted, or what are the functions. Then suspected poly or oligohydramnios. Polyhydramnios means excessive fluid in the uterine cavity, or oligo means less amniotic fluid. So it is helpful for fetus growth, fetal growth. So we detect by USG examination, either amniotic fluid is properly or not. Suspected abruptio placenta. Abruptio placenta means if placenta properly not contracted or not properly coming, so or adhere to the uterine wall during labor process. So we can manage these cases in the antenatal care. Okay, looking from breech to vertex presentation. Breech presentation or to vertex presentation, fetus coming from breech to vertex, and how can we manage by USG of these cases. Okay, then diagnosis of ectopic pregnancy. Ectopic pregnancy, you know about ectopic pregnancy. What is ectopic? Means other than the uterus. Pregnancy other than the uterus. So we can also detect by this method, by this examination. Then, now we learn about the USG application. And USG application in trimester wise we study first trimester and second and third trimester. In the first trimester, commonly performed at 9 to 12 weeks. Second and third trimester, commonly performed at 18 to 20 weeks. Obstetric USG in first trimester. In the first trimester, identification of gestational sac and embryo. Gestational sac, during first trimester, we can identify how much gestation period and gestational sac means uterus is how much enlarged regarding the pregnancy period. Then recording the presence or absence of fetal life. We can hear the fetal sound during first trimester. So here it denotes the presence or absence of fetal life. Identification and documenting the fetal number. How much fetus in the uterus we can detect by this method in the first trimester. Here you see the fetus in the intrauterine life. Then evaluation of uterus and adnexal structures. Uterus and adnexal structures. What is the position of uterus and what are the structures which is helpful for the easy delivery. Then measurement of knuckle translucency. Knuckle translucency means what are the fetal position, and we calculate from the neckline, and we will decide what is the what will the in the labor either fetus properly coming or not coming, parturition properly comes or not. Okay, then next is obstetrical USG in second and third trimester. Second and third trimester, we also learn fetal life number and presentation. Fetal life numbers, how many fetuses, and also the presentation in we detect in the second and third trimester. Amount of amniotic fluid, how much amniotic fluid we detect in the second and third trimester. Record placental localization, either placenta in place or not in second, third trimester. Fetal age and growth by fetal biometry including. Then these are the fetal diameter, biparietal diameter, head circumference, femur length, abdominal circumference. These are helpful for next coming for future purpose, or what will be the mainly process in delivery, either cesarean or either vaginal. So by these methods we can detect prognosis here. See the picture. Then evaluation of fetal amniotic structure. Fetal amniotic structure like cerebellum and cerebellar ventricles, spine, abdominal wall at the area of umbilical cord insertion. These are the fetal anatomic structure. Fetal anatomic structure we can detect or calculate what will the position during delivery. Cerebellum and cerebral ventricles, spine. These are the many things. By this we can understand the position. Then bladder and kidney. Bladder and kidney also, all four limbs, chambers of heart. These can be detected during second and third trimester. So the ultrasound is a reliable method for establishing the length of pregnancy, and in this way can improve obstetrical care. We can understand about these things and we can improve the obstetrical management, obstetrical care. So it is the end of USG indication. University Library Reference, DC Datta, and online reference, these are the my from my clinic, organ.org. Thank you.